Hello everyone, I'm Tanvi Kaur and I welcome you to this series called RBI 247. In this very series, we pick up some important financial topics and we try to discuss them with the help of different questions. So for all those who are there for the very first time, you can subscribe to our channel and you can press this bell icon so that you can get all the latest updates for our upcoming videos. You can also join our Telegram group. In this very group, we share some free quizzes, the updates for all our videos, and you can also post your queries over here. So let's get started now. This is the very first question, which says the NRCL, that is the National Asset Reconstruction Company Limited, or the so-called bad bank, has been registered. Which of the following statements correctly states the benefits it is likely to offer? So let us have a discussion about it a bit. If you remember, I believe in the month of May, I took one session where I told you that NARCL will be set up and Padma Kumar M. Nair will be appointed as its CEO. So if you haven't watched that session, you can. I think it was there in the second week of May. So what I told you were there was the concept of bad bank, that in this year's budget, our finance minister proposed to set up a separate bad bank, which will be dealing up with these stressed assets, which with the problem of rising NPAs. So this bad bank is nothing but a financial institution that will take over the bad assets of lenders and undertake their resolution. So it will comprise of an asset reconstruction company, an asset management company, which will take over these stressed assets, these stressed loans, and it will help in the resolution so that the lenders can recover their amount. So NARCL was that proposed bad bank. And now why I'm discussing it? Because this bad bank has finally taken shape. It has finally started taking shape, where this NARCL has been registered in Mumbai, okay, with certain authorized and paid up capital, and Padma Kumar M. Nair will be the one who is going to head this very bad bank. So let us see a bit about this NARCL. So it has been set up on 7th of July with 100 crore worth of authorized capital, and it has been classified as a union government company. So ye company ke taur pe 100 crore capital ke saath register kar di gayi hai. Ab isko asset reconstruction company ka license lena baki hai. So wo necessary documentation kar rahe hain, jisse ki RBI ki taraf se ARC ka license bhi unhe thode time mein mil jayega, aur shortly it is going to start its operations. So company has been set up, but ARC license is pending and it is now doing all the documentation so that it can get this approval. So once this approval comes, the NARCL is going to soon start its operations. Initially, what is going to happen? Initially, the state-run banks will transfer 22 bad loan accounts worth 89,000 crores to this NARCL. So 22 bad loan accounts jo hai jinki worth 89,000 crore ki hai, pehle NARCL unka resolution karega. Iske baad baki tranches mein 2 trillion tak ka amount hai jo decide kiya gaya hai filhal NARCL jise resolve karegi. So total bad loans worth 2 trillion are likely to be transferred in tranches to NARCL for the resolution purpose. As announced in the budget, NARCL will house the bad loan accounts of 500 crores or more. So, jo bhi stressed assets hai, bad loans hai, jinki worth 500 crore ya usse zyada ki hai, NARCL unko take over karke unka resolution karege. So, NARCL mein aapki asset reconstruction company hogi aur asset management company hogi, jisme se ek usse take over karegi, sare bad assets kharidegi banks ke, and dusri usko manage karegi, uska resolution karegi, and it will help to manage and recover the dead assets. So ARC has already been, the NARCL has already been set up. Soon it will get the ARC license, and AMC is yet to be set up. So asset management company will help in the management and recovery of these dead assets. So it is yet to be set up. Now moving ahead, why this step has been taken, why this bad bank has been set up, how is it going to help? So let's discuss a bit about it. It's going to be one-stop solution to India's bad debt, bad loan menace, and the setting up of this bad bank is part of government's effort to clean up India's financial system, which is sitting on one of the biggest pile of bad assets. So bad assets are growing, NPAs are growing. We have been discussing a lot about this NPA rising problem. So India mein bad loans kafi zyada hai, to ye ek solution ki tarah work karega jo un bad loans ko resolve karne mein help karega. जो लेंडर्स का पैसा है वो वापस रिकवर करने में उन्हें हेल्प करेगा. ट्रांसफरिंग सार्ड लोन्स टू NARCL विल अलाउ बैंक्स टू कट देयर लॉसेज एंड रिन्यू देयर लेंडिंग. सो बैंक्स यूज टू गिव द लोन्स बट इफ दे आर नॉट एबल टू रिकवर दोज लोन्स दे आर ऑब्वियसली इन लॉसेज. Had they recovered that amount, the money could have been used for lending to others as well. So banks अपना पैसा नहीं recover कर पा रहे जिसकी वजह से उन्हें losses हो रहे हैं, वो further lending नहीं कर पा रहे, तो ये problem solve हो जाएगी इस NARCL से. The primary advantage of this proposed ARC is the ability to aggregate bad loans from all members of the consortium. So why is this NARCL better vis-a-vis existing ARCs? पहले भी asset reconstruction companies exist कर रही थी, तो अलग से bad bank बनाने की जरूरत क्यों पड़ी? इसका एक बहुत major advantage है, which is this, that it will help in quick decision making because it offers the benefit of aggregating the debt. So let's see what is it. At present, most asset reconstruction companies buy bad assets from individual banks, while other banks may choose not to part with their exposure in the loan, because of which quick decision making is not possible. Okay, and thus the resolution is not done in a very time-bound manner. So this ARC will handle the assets above 500 crore, and main advantage is debt aggregation, because of which quick decision making is possible. So आपने loans दे रखे हैं, okay? अलग अलग banks ने एक borrower को loan दिए होंगे. जब कोई asset reconstruction company, suppose कोई private asset reconstruction company है, वो एक bad loan एक bank से वो bad उसके bad assets खरीद लेती है, तो उसी पर्सन ने जो लोन ले रखा है, उसी कंपनी ने जो लोन ले रखा है, वो कहीं और से भी ले रखा होगा. ओके, 500 करोड़ का अमाउंट है, 250 करोड़ सपोज एक जगह से लिए, या 100 करोड़ 50 करोड़ एक जगह से लिए, बाकी कहीं और से ले रखे हैं. तो असेट रिकंस्ट्रक्शन कंपनी बस उस इंडिविजुअल बैंक का बैड लोन खरीद लेती है, बाकी एक्सपोजर जो है उसका दूसरे बैंक से जो लोन ले रखा है वो टेक ओवर नहीं कर पाती, जिसकी वजह से जब कोई डिसीजन लेना हो, रेजोल्यूशन प्रोसेस करना हो, तो प्रॉब्लम आती है. अब ये ARC जो है ये पूरा डेट टेक ओवर करेगी और उसको रिजॉल्व करेगी. दैट्स द बेनिफिट. अदर देन दैट, वन मेजर बेनिफिट इज दैट द एग्जिस्टिंग ARCs वर मोर ऑफ हैविंग मोर ऑफ अ प्राइवेट स्टेक, बट हेयर दिस बैड बैंक हैज बीन सजेस्टेड बाय गवर्नमेंट, सो इट इज गोइंग टू हैव अ मेजर stake of the government. The public sector banks, all 12 public sector banks are thinking to have a stake in this, so it is a more safer option because government is backing it. Obviously private banks are also investing, having stake in this ARC or this bad bank, but government stake is there, government support is there, because of which they are more preferred vis-a-vis existing ARCs. Okay, so moving ahead now, all 12 public sector banks and 4 private lenders, that is HDFC, ICICI, Axis Bank and IDBI Bank, are going to invest in this bad bank. Now what will this asset reconstruction company do? It will take over the bad loans, and in return it will give 15% amount in cash and 85% in government guaranteed security receipts. So the previous session which I took on NARCL, I discussed about this, that how security receipt is basically an evidence that you are having some financial asset against which you are getting the right. Okay, it's the evidence purchase. Evidence is the purchase or acquisition by the holder of some right title in a financial asset. So, आपको cash ना देके एक receipt issue की जाती है कि आपके इतने worth की assets हमारे पास हैं, and you can utilize those receipts later on. So, this was a bit more about it. Now, let's move back to our question. Which of these is a benefit? First one is a benefit that it will help in cleaning up the bad assets. Second is also benefit. It will benefit banks by renewing lending and cutting their losses. Third is also correct. The aggregating debt problem will be resolved. So answer is option E, that all are the benefits. Okay, all are correct. It's better if this option says all statements are correct. Okay. Now moving to next question, which says, banks such as India's largest private sector bank ICICI has asked customers remitting funds to invest abroad to give a declaration that money will not be invested to buy Bitcoin or other cryptocurrencies. Indian investors taking foreign remittance under the LRS, that is the liberalized remittance scheme route, to buy current cryptocurrencies on foreign exchanges. Which of the following is incorrectly related to this LRS? So let's discuss what is this very thing. Recently, ICICI Bank has shut down the LRS stores for the crypto traders. So if you are remitting the money through LRS scheme, you can't use that money for investing in Bitcoin or other cryptocurrency. This is what ICICI Bank has said. So the Indian investors often take foreign remittance route under LRS scheme to buy cryptocurrencies. What is this LRS scheme? LRS stands for Liberalized Remittance Scheme. ये एक RBI की scheme है जिससे कि जो resident individuals हैं वो अपना पैसा एक financial year में worth of 2,50,000 डॉलर्स, 2,50,000 डॉलर्स तक का अमाउंट आप दूसरी कंट्री में रेमिट कर सकते हो, इन्वेस्ट कर सकते हो, एक्सपेंडिचर कर सकते हो. सो द अमाउंट विच यू आर रेमिटिंग टू अदर नेशन, इट शुड नॉट एक्सीड 2,50,000 डॉलर्स पर ईयर. एंड वॉट फॉर वॉट पर्पजेज कैन दैट बी यूटिलाइज? उस पैसे को आप वहाँ पे ट्रैवलिंग के एक्सपेंसेस के लिए यूज़ कर सकते हो, मेडिकल एक्सपेंडिचर के लिए यूज़ कर सकते हो, पढ़ाई के लिए यूज़ कर सकते हो, फॉर स्टडीज, फॉर गिविंग एज अ गिफ्ट, डोनेशन. आप उस पैसे को वहाँ की शेयर्स में, डेट इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स में, अलग अलग इमूवेबल प्रॉपर्टीज में भी इन्वेस्ट कर सकते हो. सो लिबरलाइज स्कीम अलाउ इट्स RBI रिकॉग्नाइज स्कीम विच अलाउज द इंडिविजुअल्स टू रेमिट फंड्स टू अदर कंट्रीज फॉर इन्वेस्टमेंट एंड एक्सपेंडिचर. एंड द अमाउंट विच इज अलाउड टू रेमिट इज 2,50,000 डॉलर्स. Okay, so these are the purposes for which you can utilize that very amount for your medical treatment, studies, expenses in traveling, gifts, donations, investments, etc. So now what ICICI Bank has said is that you can't utilize that LRS money to invest in the cryptocurrencies. Now, why this step has been taken by ICICI? The allure of get rich quick is leading Indian crypto punters to take leveraged bets on foreign cryptocurrency exchanges and to avail the services that are not available on domestic exchanges. Indian customers are remitting funds abroad through LRS route to buy cryptocurrencies that are not available on local exchanges. Now, these cryptocurrencies, people think that they will earn a lot, they will get rich quickly, so people want to invest in these. Now, lot of cryptocurrency dealings are not allowed in the Indian exchanges, so they prefer going to some other foreign exchange where these cryptocurrencies can be bought and sold. So what they are doing, through LRS, you can remit some amount abroad, okay, you can invest it elsewhere, you can use it for different purposes which I just stated. So what they are doing, they are using this LRS scheme and the money which is being remitted, they are using it to invest in cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin and all. Okay, so some of them are also using credit card to make such investments. Now credit card is like a loan taken, you have to repay, and if you're using that to invest in these cryptocurrencies, what can happen if you are not able to earn good enough amount on cryptocurrencies, if they just drop down a lot and you will lose out the money, you won't be able to repay. So it's highly risky business to use these credit cards to invest in such cryptocurrencies. This is forcing the hand of Indian banks to deter punters from restraining such trades abroad. ये बहुत रिस्की है, कोई रेगुलेटेड, प्रॉपरली रेगुलेटेड नहीं है क्रिप्टो करेंसी, इसलिए हमारे रेगुलेटर्स भी सपोर्ट नहीं कर रहे कि इसमें इन्वेस्ट किया जाए. ओके, सो ICICI बैंक ने अब फाइनली ये बोल दिया है कि आपको डिक्लेरेशन देना पड़ेगा कि अगर आप LRS के थ्रू पैसा रेमिट कर रहे हो बाहर, तो आप उसको क्रिप्टो करेंसीज में इन्वेस्ट नहीं करोगे. इट्स हाईली रिस्की, सो वी कांट टेक दी We should not take the risk and we should deter from indulging in such investments in cryptocurrencies. So what step has been taken by ICICI? It is telling its customers that remitting money abroad for investment purposes to provide a declaration that funds will not be used to buy cryptocurrencies. ICICI has modified its retail outward remittance application, which is required to be signed by customers before they transfer funds abroad. For what purpose? For investment in these, stocks, properties abroad under LRS scheme. So the ICICI Bank has asked the customers that if they have to remit some money as per LRS, okay, in their retail outward remittance application, they have to sign a declaration that they will not use this money to invest in cryptocurrencies. ये पैसा cryptocurrencies में invest नहीं होगा, ऐसा आपको declaration sign करके देना पड़ेगा आईसीआईसीआई बैंक को अगर आप उनके थ्रू ये रेमिटेंस कर रहे हो। इसके अलावा ना ही सिर्फ उन्होंने रिस्ट्रेन किया है आपको क्रिप्टो करेंसीज में इन्वेस्ट करने से, बट दे हैव ऑल्सो टोल्ड कि आप म्यूचुअल फंड्स या अदर ऐसे इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स में भी इन्वेस्ट नहीं करोगे जो क्रिप्टो करेंसीज में डील करते हैं। सो दिस इज अनदर थिंग दैट यू कांट इन्वेस्ट इन म्यूचुअल फंड्स और अदर कैपिटल इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स विच डील इन दीज क्रिप्टो करेंसीज। सो दीज टू डिक्लेरेशंस यू हैव टू साइन अंडर दिस रेमिटेंस एप्लीकेशन। दिस इज द एप्लीकेशन, आई विल शो इट टू यू। So this is the ICICI Bank's Retail Outward Remittance application. Here you have to sign a declaration that the above remittance is not for investment in Bitcoin, cryptocurrency, virtual currency like Ethereum, Litecoin, Dash, Dogecoin, etc. The above remittance is not for investment in mutual funds or other capital instruments that deal in Bitcoins, cryptocurrency or virtual certificates. So अब आपको ये declaration sign करना पड़ेगा अगर आप ICICI बैंक के थ्रू रेमिटेंस करना चाहते हो। ऑल्दो देर इज नो पेनल्टी विच हैज बीन डिफाइंड बाय द रेगुलेटर इफ कस्टमर वायलेट्स दिस डिक्लेरेशन, बट द अकाउंट कैन गेट सस्पेंडेड। ऐसा कुछ नहीं है कि अगर आपने ये डिक्लेरेशन साइन किया है तब भी आप इन्वेस्टमेंट करते हो तो आपको कोई पेनल्टी लगाई जाएगी, बट ऑब्वियसली आपने डिक्लेरेशन साइन किया था तो ICICI बैंक आपका अकाउंट सस्पेंड कर सकता है। एंड दीज थिंग्स आर बीइंग फॉलोड टू मेक श्योर कस्टमर्स डोंट एंगेज इन these risky asset class, okay, it's highly volatile class, so it's better not to go for them or invest in them. That's why our banks are not supporting it, and also there is no clear cut picture as to what is going to be the cryptocurrency future in India. Now moving back to our question, which of this is incorrectly related to our LRS? First one is correctly related, okay, but second and third are incorrectly related because here the amount is 2,50,000, which is correct, and they say that this money can't be used to pay expenses of traveling medical. No, it can be used. So this is also incorrect. Second and third are incorrect. Answer is option D. Moving on to question number 3 now, which says Retail Direct scheme has now been issued by RBI as a one-stop solution to facilitate investment in government securities by individual investors. So the retail investors will have the facility to open a Retail Direct GILT account with RBI. RDG account can be opened through online portal provided for the purpose of the scheme. Which of the following service is or are provided to registered investors through this online portal? So let us study a bit about this very scheme. RBI Retail Direct Scheme. RBI Retail Direct Facility was announced in the Statement of Development and Regulatory Policies in the month of February in order to improve the ease of access by retail investors to the government securities, along with facility to open GILT securities account. So if you remember, in the month of February, RBI in its Statement of Development and Regulatory Policies told that it will come up with a Retail Direct scheme, that a Retail Direct facility will be offered where retail investors are the investors like us, the non-professional investors, the individual investors, okay, which are not the big institutional investors. So these retail investors are also allowed to invest in government securities, and they will be allowed to open GILT securities account with RBI to deal in these government securities. February mein ye notification aaya tha ki RBI ab retail investors ko bhi allow kar raha hai government securities khareedne ke liye. So in pursuance of that announcement, ab ye scheme aayi hai. Now this RBI Retail Direct scheme has been issued, whose date of commencement will be announced later on. So what is this very scheme? सबसे पहले हम बात करेंगे कि यहाँ कहा गया है कि गवर्नमेंट सिक्योरिटीज में रिटेल इन्वेस्टर्स इन्वेस्ट कर सकते हैं। रिटेल इन्वेस्टर्स कैन नाउ इन्वेस्ट इन गवर्नमेंट सिक्योरिटीज। सो व्हाट आर दीज गवर्नमेंट सिक्योरिटीज? दीज आर दी ट्रेडेबल इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स एंड दीज आर इशूड बाय होम, बाय द गवर्नमेंट, बाय द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट, बाय द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट, विच एक्नोलेजेस एंड गवर्नमेंट्स डेट ऑब्लिगेशन। सो दीज आर सिक्योरिटीज क्रिएटेड बाय गवर्नमेंट। Okay, government issues them, we can buy those securities, and this way government can raise some amount from us now. Okay, तो ये security issue करके government हमसे पैसा raise कर सकती है. In India, central government issues treasury bills, bonds or dated securities. Other than that, state government issue the bonds or dated securities called state development loans. So these are the government securities or the G-Secs, what we call. So G-Secs carry practically no risk of default and hence are called risk-free gilt-edged instruments. So, इनकी risk बहुत कम या almost negligible होती है क्योंकि ये government-backed हैं. So, what are gilt-edged instruments? Gilt-edged securities are instruments are the high-grade investment bonds. Okay, these are offered by the government or by really very large corporations as a means of borrowing funds. So, now retail investors can open gilt account. So what is a gilt account? It's an account which is open to hold the government securities. जैसे कि हमारा normal bank account होता है ना, जहाँ हम पैसा जमा करते हैं, withdraw करते हैं, we debit and credit money in a normal bank account. Similarly, we have a gilt account, but here instead of debiting crediting money, we debit credit government securities. तो यहाँ हम पैसा जमा करते या निकालते नहीं है, यहाँ पे हम government securities, T-bills वगैरह जो है उसको deposit करते हैं या withdraw करते हैं, उसका debit या credit होता है basically. That's a gilt account. So it's this scheme is a solution to facilitate government securities investment by individual investors. Individual investors can now open this account, the retail direct gilt account. हम जैसे लोग अब retail direct gilt account बना के government securities में invest कर सकते हैं. And this account can be opened through the online portal. Okay, through their online portal we can apply for registration, and once we get registered, we can deal in these government securities. So what facilities is this online portal going to offer us? It is going to offer us two basic facilities. First is to access primary issuance of government security, and second is access NDS OM. So we can do the primary issue of government security. Initial जो issue होता है, initially हम खरीदते हैं, that's a government security. उसके बाद उसकी dealing होती है, वो secondary market में होती है. So primary dealing हम कर सकते हैं government securities की, और secondary dealing भी कर सकते हैं. Secondary market में हम NDS OM के through deal कर सकते हैं. NDS OM stands for Negotiated Dealing System, Order Matching System. What is it? It's a electronic system, RBI recognized system, which allows us to trade in these government securities in the secondary market. So we can do the primary issue of government securities, and through NDS OM, which is an electronic system, we can trade in these government securities in the secondary market as well. Now, why this scheme has been launched? First, as I've already told you, it will allow the investment by the individual investors in G-Secs. So it will democratize the ownership of government debt securities beyond banks and managers of pooled resources like mutual funds. So the current G-Sec market is dominated by institutional investors, which are large market actors like banks and all. So these entities trade in a great lot size of 5 crores or more. ये बड़े बड़े amount के investment करते हैं G-Secs में जो बड़े institutional investors हैं, जिस वजह से जो retail investors हैं उनके लिए इतनी liquidity नहीं रहती थी जो secondary market में. So there was no liquidity in secondary market for small investors. There was no easy way for them to exit their investments. Thus, G-Secs trading was not popular among retail investors. इसलिए retail investors में G-Sec trading कॉमन नहीं थी, क्योंकि ह्यूज अमाउंट इन्वेस्ट करते थे बड़े बड़े इन्वेस्टर्स, और उसकी वजह से सेकेंडरी मार्केट में लिक्विडिटी इतनी नहीं होती थी कि छोटे इन्वेस्टर थोड़ा बहुत अमाउंट इन्वेस्ट कर लें या विड्रॉ कर लें. तो ये जो स्कीम है, इट इज गोइंग टू हेल्प विद दैट रिगार्ड. दस दिस स्टेप विल मेक द प्रोसेस ऑफ G-Sec ट्रेडिंग स्मूदर फॉर स्मॉल इन्वेस्टर्स एंड इंक्रीज द रिटेल पार्टिसिपेशन इन G-Secs एंड इम्प्रूव द ईज ऑफ एक्सेस. It is also going to help in the government borrowings. Government अब retail investors से भी पैसा raise कर सकती है. This measure will facilitate smooth completion of government borrowing program. Okay, government can raise now money from the retail investors as well. Now discussing a bit more about the scheme. So the scope of scheme first, it's a comprehensive scheme where what facilities will be offered through the online portal. It will allow us to open a retail direct gilt account. We discussed that account open to buy, sell government securities is this account. We can access the primary issue of government securities and through NDS OM the secondary issue. So, hum retail gilt account khol sakte hain, jisme hum apni government securities hold karenge. Hum government securities ko primary market mein bhi issue kar sakte hain aur secondary market mein bhi unki dealing kar sakte hain through NDS OM. So, this is the scope of the scheme. Talking about the process, the investor has to register on the online portal. After the registration is complete, this retail direct gilt account will be opened, and once this account is open, you can go for primary market or secondary market participation. Okay, so aapko online portal mein apply karna padega, aapko proper OTP aayega, details li jayengi, aapka successful registration jab ho jayega to aapka gilt account khola jayega, and through that you can deal in the government securities then. टॉकिंग अबाउट हु इज एलिजिबल, तो हमारे जो जो भी रेसिडेंट्स हैं दे आर एलिजिबल प्रोवाइडेड दैट दे हैव अ रुपी सेविंग्स अकाउंट इन इंडिया, दे हैव अ पैन नंबर, दे हैव ऑफिशियल वैलिड डॉक्यूमेंट फॉर KYC पर्पस एंड दे हैव वैलिड ईमेल आईडी एंड रजिस्टर्ड मोबाइल नंबर. तो रेसिडेंट्स जिनके पास ये सारी डिटेल्स या रिक्वायरमेंट्स फुलफिल जो कर रहे हैं वो एलिजिबल है. इसके अलावा नॉन रेसिडेंट रिटेल इन्वेस्टर्स जो फॉरन एक्सचेंज मैनेजमेंट एक्ट के अकॉर्डिंग अलाउड, जिन्हें अलाउड है गवर्नमेंट सिक्योरिटीज में इन्वेस्ट करना, वो इस स्कीम के अंदर भी एलिजिबल है. ओके, सो नॉन रेसिडेंट रिटेल इन्वेस्टर्स एलिजिबल टू इन्वेस्ट इन गवर्नमेंट सिक्योरिटीज अंडर फॉरन एक्सचेंज मैनेजमेंट एक्ट आर एलिजिबल अंडर दिस स्कीम एज वेल. RDG अकाउंट कैन बी ओपन सिंगली और इट कैन बी ओपन एज अ जॉइंट अकाउंट विद सम अदर रिटेल इन्वेस्टर एज वेल. तो आप इसका सिंगल अकाउंट भी खोल सकते हो, जॉइंट अकाउंट भी खोल सकते हो किसी और रिटेल इन्वेस्टर के साथ. Talking about what services this portal is going to offer. Okay, this is our what our question talks about. First is account statement. This means that you can get the access to your transaction history, your balance position. आप securities में deal कर रहे हो, debit हो रहा है, amount credit हो रहा है, तो पूरी statement आपको online portal में मिल जाएगी. Second is the nomination facility. अब हो सकता है कि जो person ने government securities खरीद रखी थी, that person dies, तो उसकी securities का क्या होगा? तो आप नॉमिनी अपॉइंट कर सकते हो और वो सिक्योरिटीज आपकी नॉमिनी को ट्रांसफर हो जाएंगी. ये फैसिलिटी भी ये पोर्टल ऑफर करता है. देयर कैन बी मैक्सिमम ऑफ टू नॉमिनीज. ओके, इफ द पर्सन डाइज हु विल डील इन दोज सिक्योरिटीज, हु विल होल्ड दैट सिक्योरिटीज, द नॉमिनी. सो इन द इवेंट ऑफ डेथ ऑफ द रजिस्टर्ड इन्वेस्टर द सिक्योरिटीज अवेलेबल इन द अकाउंट विल बी ट्रांसमिटेड टू द अकाउंट ऑफ द नॉमिनी. थर्ड फैसिलिटी विच इज ऑफर इज प्लेज और लियन. सो यू कैन प्लेज योर सिक्योरिटीज. ओके, आप अपनी सिक्योरिटीज प्लेज करके उसके अगेंस्ट लोन रेज कर सकते हो. यू कैन रेज लोन्स बाय प्लेजिंग योर सिक्योरिटीज. फोर्थ फैसिलिटी इज द गिफ्ट फैसिलिटी. यू कैन गिफ्ट योर गवर्नमेंट सिक्योरिटीज टू सम अदर रिटेल इन्वेस्टर्स एज वेल. आपके पास ये फैसिलिटी है कि आप अपनी गवर्नमेंट सिक्योरिटीज को किसी और इन्वेस्टर को गिफ्ट कर सकते हो. एंड देन वी हैव ई ग्रीवेंस रिड्रेसल. आपको कोई प्रॉब्लम है, रिजॉल्व करनी है, आप उसको ऑनलाइन पोर्टल के थ्रू अप्लाई कर सकते हो और RBI का जो भी बॉडी उसके साथ डील करती है वो आपको रिजोल्यूशन देगी उस चीज़ का. एनी क्वेरी और ग्रीवेंस रिलेटेड टू रिटेल डायरेक्ट स्कीम कैन बी रेज ऑन द पोर्टल. सो वंस यू रेज दैट क्वेरी ऑन द पोर्टल इट विल गेट रिजॉल्व बाय RBI. सो दिस वॉज अबाउट इन्वेस्टमेंट सर्विसेज. Sorry, this was about the investor services, and last is the fee and the charges. So there's no fee charged to open account, to maintain this gilt account. There is no fee charged when you are submitting bids in the primary auction, but some fees charged for the payment gateway as which applicable, that has to be borne by the registered investor. So koi bahut zyada fees nahi hai iski. This was all about this very scheme. Now if we move back to the question, which of these is not a service provided to registered investors under this online portal? Account statement is a service provided, nomination pledge, DIRN facility is also provided, gift facility is also provided, e-grievance redressal is also provided. So none of these is the facility which is not provided. That's why the answer is E. In me se koi aisi cheez nahi hai jo nahi provide ki jati, isliye answer hai none of the above. This was all for today's session. I hope this session was useful for you. With this, I would like to end up this session. Thank you so much.